I marvel at how our Creator has held back His anger upon the inhabitants of the world the way that He has. He has done so with remarkable patience. He has done so for the sake of those whom He has been calling to become His eternal family. I marvel at His strategy in sending me with a small, quiet voice for the first 3 years of the 3.5-year prophecy that He has sent me to you with. His doing so has not only testified to His word, it has been a witness that the truth would not be embraced by the inhabitants of the world until He humbles them with great wrath. And even then, only a few of you will hearken to Him. The witness that He has sent me with has been a witness against you that His word has no place in your rebellious hearts. His word is not your course, the course of your heart, and it is not your measuring rod. After He gave Moses the second set of tablets, His word says in Exodus chapter 34, Yahweh passed by before Him and proclaimed, Yahweh Elohim is full of compassion and slow to anger and abundantly gives favor and loving kindness and truth. And I will preserve my loving kindness upon thousands of you and lift your iniquity and your rebellion and your sin from you. But I will not acquit the guilty. I will visit the iniquity of the fathers upon the children and upon the children's children unto the third and to the fourth generation. When He was giving us the commandments through His servant Moses a few chapters earlier, He spoke the requirement that we must do in order to be of the thousands who would receive His favor. He said in Exodus 20, verse 6, I will show loving kindness unto the thousands of you that love me and guard or hedge about my commandments. His son even said that if we truly do love Him, then we will obey the commandments. Loving Him is loving His righteousness that His word testifies to. It is loving His word. And living His word in spirit and in truth is what teaches us to become His righteousness. Yahweh went on in the next verse to say that He will not hold those of you guiltless who bear His name in a desolating way. This agrees with what I just read to you back in chapter 34. He said that He will not acquit those of you who are guilty. The guilty are the condemned. They are those of you who continue to rebel against His word and continue in your sin and in your iniquity. I'll read to you in a bit where His son said the same thing. Our repentance is required in order for Him to lift our iniquity from us. And in the next verse, after saying that He will not hold you guiltless if you bear His name in a desolating way, He spoke that we must remember His Sabbaths. Nearly all of you cannot even obey a simple commandment like hearkening to His instructions for His day of rest each week. At best, most of you tell Him how and when you will come before Him. He gave a song to His servant Moses to record that He commanded us to all know and to teach to our children. This song was given to us to be a witness against the descendants of Israel in the last days. In this song, He explained why He is sending His wrath upon those whom he will send it upon. He said that He is sending it upon you because of your rebellion to His word. He said in verse 34 of this song found in Deuteronomy 32, He said, is this not laid up in my storehouse and sealed up among my depository? He is asking you, is not his anger with you justified? To me belongs vengeance and recompense. Therefore, in its time, your foot will fall. The day of your calamity is prepared to hastily come to you, says Yahweh. And it is, we are at its time. Verse 36, because I will judge my people and side of myself for my subjects when I see that your power is gone and there is none to set you free. Even in this verse, He is saying that His wrath will be accomplished quickly. His word says that much of it will be accomplished in one day. The point of this video is that He is slow to anger, but He is slow to anger to a particular group. He has just held back His anger for this group's sake. He said in Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 11, say to them, as I live, saith Yahweh Elohim, my pleasure is not in the death of the wicked, or in other words, the death of the condemned, but rather that the wicked would turn or repent from his pathway or his course and live. Repent, repent from your perverse course. For why die, O house of Israel? He goes on to give a detailed description of your rebellion and the need for you to turn from it, or dying you will die. He says in verse 21 that you are going to be smitten if you do not. He associates this smiting with the one that escapes from your midst and with the fifth day of the 10th month. The fifth day of the 10th month on Yahweh's restored calendar will be this December 18th on Satan's calendar. December 18th is 33 days before January 20th. Is this 33 days another coincidence? I'll share with you yet another coincidence that he is tying in with this prophecy for you to turn from your course or you will be smitten. Yahweh said that he remembered Noah 157 days after he told him to start loading the ark on the 10th day of the second month. 157 days before January 20th will be August 16th. August 16th will also be the first day of the sixth month on Yahweh's restored calendar. Haggai's prophecy concerning Zerubbabel began on the first day of the sixth month. As this prophecy begins, Yahweh poses the question for you to consider the pathway or the course that is in your heart. He actually asks this question twice. The prophecy is about him building his house. Then he speaks about him calling for a drought on the land in this prophecy. In lieu of Noah's first 157 days and then Yahweh remembering Noah, is it a coincidence that Yahweh's word says that he will call for a drought and the date that his word says this will be, it will be 157 days prior to January 20th? Especially in lieu of this prophecy also being about Zerubbabel? Haggai's prophecy then extends into 23 more days to the 24th day of the sixth month. I'll share with you a mirror of this 23 days. August 16th will be 23 days after July 24th, which will be the end of the 3 years of Isaiah's prophecy of me walking naked and barefoot. In Ezekiel 33:21, he is speaking about the city being smitten, ties in this prophecy with the description of who will be smitten that is found in Ezekiel chapter 9. Here is the description. Verse 6, slay utterly the old and the young, both the virgins and the women with their families, but do not come near all men who have Yahweh's mark. And begin at my sanctuary. Begin with the men who are the elders that stand before the house of Israel. In other words, begin with the false shepherds. Do you have Yahweh's mark in your forehead, or do you have the mark of the beast? Yahweh's mark is given to those who cry and sigh for all of the rebellion to his word that is done in their midst. Satan's mark is found in those of you who live in rebellion to Yahweh's word. In Ezekiel 33, Yahweh's word says that the fifth day of the 10th month prophecy of the city being smitten is associated with one escaping and coming to you. This, along with other prophecies, ties this servant in with Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel means one who escapes or flows out from the captivity. I said that I would read to you our Messiah's description of who will be condemned, found in John 3:18. He that believes into me, therefore he that believes into his Father's word, since he was made in the image of his Father's word, and he was given the name, his Father's word, to be his name. He says, he that believes into his Father's word will not be condemned, but he that does not believe into his Father's word is condemned already, because he has not believed into the name of Yahweh's only begotten Son. Could this be any simpler than it is? Yes, Yahweh is slow to anger, but like I said, he is slow to anger with a particular group. This group is those who turn from their rebellion to his course and desire his course. His loving kindness and his favor is bestowed on those who hunger and thirst for his kingdom and for his righteousness. It is bestowed upon those who seize his righteousness. The favor of his son's atoning blood is given to those who repent from the rebellion to his word. Rebellion to his word is rebellion to his son. Therefore, it is rebellion to the atoning sacrifice that he set up through his son. Repenting is turning to live his course in order to become as he is, in order to be found in his favor. His son's atoning blood is the favor for favor. His word says that Zerubbabel will bring forth his son shouting favor for favor. This is recorded in Zechariah chapter 4. Then the angel answered and spoke to me, saying, this is Yahweh's word that is upon Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says Yahweh of hosts. Who are you, great mountain? Before Zerubbabel's face you will become a plain, and he will bring forth the headstone, before he bring forth the Messiah, shouting favor for favor to him. Yahweh's anger is about to be unleashed upon those of you who continue to rebel against his requirement that he gave to us to live in order to be found in his favor. You are about ready to find out that he has merely held back his wrath for the sake of those who he was calling to become his eternal children. And he has done so in his end time timeline as well to testify to his word and to testify to his desire for you to not choose to die, but rather for you to repent and live. I'll read what he said concerning this again, Ezekiel 33:11, say to them, as I live, says Yahweh Elohim, my pleasure is not in the death of the wicked, but rather that the wicked would turn or repent from his pathway and live. Repent from your perverse course. For why die, O house of Israel? And if you do repent by turning to living to be found in his favor, you will receive his favor. Favor for favor. Thus saith Elohim.